Finally, I got my hands on the new MacBook with the M1 chip. This is the MacBook Air. The unboxing experience is exactly the same as the one that I experienced with my older MacBook 2017. The difference between the M1 Air and the M1 Pro is that the Pro has one GPU core more, 8 cores instead of 7 of this MacBook Air, and that it has active cooling. I'm going to use this unboxing clip, which is in 4K 30fps, to do a comparison between the older Intel i5 MacBook Pro with this new MacBook Air with the M1 chip. After I import this clip on the two machines, I'm going to do three tests. First, it will be the initial render. Then I'm going to apply a color correction, and then I'm going to export the clips. Dropping the four recorded clips on the timeline, the automatic render starts. MacBook Air does it in 2 minutes and 30 seconds, and the MacBook Pro takes a very long time indeed, as you can see, and does it in 19 minutes and 33 seconds. I'm applying a color coding on the timeline. You can see the progress bar on the top left corner. MacBook Air finishes just 2 minutes and 44 seconds, and the MacBook Pro is just at 9%. Last test is exporting the video in 4K 30fps for Apple computers. On both MacBooks, I have the clips and the exported videos on their internal SSDs. It's already apparent that the exporting on the M1 chip is not as fast as the previous test. MacBook Air with the M1 chip just finished after 3 minutes. First two tests were 100% computational and the M1 was 10 times faster. Now this time it will be just sort of twice as fast for exporting a video as the Pro. That did it in 5 minutes and 38 seconds. Conclusion: the MacBook Air for render or color coding is 10 times faster, and for exporting the video, just 2 times faster.